Hey, welcome to Fitz on Flicks. I'm Fitz. This is my friend Murph.
What's up, liar?
Hey, nothing much, truth taker. We saw this week a movie called Invention of Lying, starring Ricky Gervais, the British phenom behind such successes as The Office, the original Office, and Extras. Murph, what is this movie about? Did you like it? Did you not? Please tell the people.
Do I have to tell?
I swear I wish you would.
Okay, we're in current day, I guess America at this point in the movie, and nobody has ever told a lie. Everybody tells the truth. We haven't evolved yet. The humans haven't evolved to actually speak of lies. Until one day, Ricky Gervais' character, Mark?
Mark.
Mark figures out that he can lie. And as he progresses to lie about things, he realizes that everybody believes his every word. So he's got a love interest in the movie, Jennifer Garner, which he's trying to get with. And that's pretty much a running theme in the movie. And then he's got other friends. I don't know if we're giving away too much by saying what happens to him. He kind of gets successful and famous for a couple of big lies that he gives out. But it's basically about that. It's about his character and his quest for love and appreciation of life. Yeah. What'd you think?
I hated it. This movie, Ricky Gervais, I really, really like Ricky Gervais. Most people who like funny things, who like good comp, they like Ricky Gervais. This guy is, there's very few people as talented as him out there and as funny as him. So I don't know how this happened. This movie, this Invention of Lying, it's a one joke movie. It's one joke. Is that nobody can lie, okay? So the movie basically starts out, people are so brutally honest, they're like, oh, you're fat, you're gross, you're terrible, and poor Ricky Gervais, oh, well, okay. And then he goes to the next place, and oh, you're fat, you're gross, you're terrible, oh, because too bad nobody can lie. And, you know, no one can tell the truth. And this goes on and on. And yeah, then he figures out he can lie. And, oh, no matter what he says, they believe him. Ha, ha, ha. No matter what he says, they believe him. Ha, ha, ha. And this just keeps happening. This would have been a great Saturday Night Live skit. This would have been a great SCTV skit. This would have been a good skit, a 5-10 minute. It goes on way too long. I got so bored by this. I laughed, I think, once or twice in the first 10 minutes, maybe. And that was really about it. I don't know what happened here, Ricky, but I thought this movie was awful.
You're so stupid.
I hope.
You know what? No, because I understand what you're saying. It got a little tiresome, some of the jokes, but they were really funny. I mean, these, you get the premise of everyone telling the truth. And yes, Ricky makes himself the guy who nobody likes. Even though he's a really nice guy, nobody likes him. He's ugly. He's got a snub nose. And you see him, once he learns to lie, it would have been easy for him to do all these bad things. There's actually a scene where he talks to a girl and says, we have to have sex to save the world.
That pissed me off, too. And not that he did it, but because he didn't do it.
Right, because
his conscience took over. Idiot.
I know. But that could have been a whole nother movie. But instead, he's trying to do the right thing, even by lying. He doesn't know it's bad, necessarily. But I think his character does a lot of good. I wasn't really happy about the ending, but I thought the movie overall was pretty funny, and it had some good messages to it.
First of all, just because you can't lie, does it mean you have no restraint? That's what I kept asking myself in this movie, too. Okay, somebody can't lie. If someone says, oh, hey, am I fat? And they can't lie, so they can't say, no, you're thin. They can't say that, they can't lie. Because you can't lie, does that mean you have to constantly be telling people exactly what's on your mind? If you see someone and go, oh, that's gross, or oh, those are terrible shoes. People don't have restraint. They don't have to lie to show restraint. In this movie, nobody has restraint. And that, again, I just found it annoying.
Well, see, that's going to make a very boring movie. You said it was boring anyways, but it's even more boring if you're like, so what do you think of those guys over there? Oh, they're stupid. What do you think of my shirt? It's stupid. If you don't have people coming out and just saying it, that's going to be even worse.
Right, but I mean, it was, you know, it wasn't just lack of not being able to lie, lack of not being able to have restraint. I'm just saying that was one of the problems in the writing of this movie, I think. that, having no line, there are a number of other problems there. I just thought, I'll tell you one thing, some movies this works. Blues Brothers, for example, there are a million different stars in Blues Brothers, mm-hmm. and it never takes you out of the movie. I think it almost adds to the movie. This movie, there are so many phenomenal comedians in this movie, or comedic actors, be it Louis C.K., be it Tina Fey, be it, you know, all that rhymes. There's just a number of people, Jeffrey Tambor, blah, 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 it goes on and on. But they came at you at such a feverish pace. That actually took me out of the movie, too, a little bit sometimes. Because some of them, they had such a tiny part, and it was just another, somebody else to give him an, you know, you're fat, you're whatever. That took me out of the movie. So many things. I did not like this movie. I gotta say, the invention of lying is pretty much not good.
You're dumb. Fact.
I hope you're lying. anyways, so I'm saying don't see Invention of Lying. It is yuck.
Murph. I say go see it, especially if you like Ricky G.
I think if you like Ricky G, don't see it so you'll continue to like Ricky G. But you know what you will like? I'll tell you what you'll like. Going to FitsOnFlix.com, watching Fits on Flicks, that's going to give you a cinematic boner. Check us out, FitsOnFlix.com. We look forward to seeing you soon. We might not see you for a while. We're going to be gone for a few weeks, but we will be back. Yep. Stop crying. You'll see us sometime in November. We'll talk to you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.